section, we're going to talk about 3.4, which is the slope of the line. Again, the slope is actually the elevation of how steep, essentially, is a line. So you, a lot of times, will see this if you drive in the mountains. You'll see it for the trucks, so that it tells them how steep a line is, and they'll oftentimes have a spot where they can go off the road if to slow them down, for example. You'll see this with elevation of roofs. So there's lots of areas, a treadmill. So first thing I want you to make sure you understand is there are two ways that you're going to be asked essentially to know how to calculate slope. So anytime they ask you about slope, two options. One, you're given 2 points, which is this first one right here. If you're given 2 points, you're going to use rise over run, which is, again, rise is the y values, over run, which is the x values. So y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And what I essentially always say to do, it doesn't really matter which one you call point 1 or point 2, but you have to make sure you've put the right one together. So I always go and look from the bottom up before I simplify. I'm always finding the difference as well. So a lot of times you'll see me write change in y over change in x. So the triangle means that change value. So we're going to go ahead and do that first problem. I recommend when you're doing your homework to write the formula down every single time because it needs to be memorized. And if you have it wrong, the whole problem is wrong. So I'm going to call my second one, my y2x and x2, my second point. So -3 minus 7, 4 minus a -2. So what I want you to recognize I did right there is I can check. I didn't change any signs. So this is 4, -3. This is -2, 7. So I do that before I simplify anything. So on the top, it actually becomes -3 plus a -7. Again, a lot of y'all will skip that step. In the bottom, it becomes 4 plus 2. So we get a -10 over 6, which simplifies down to a -5 over 3. So I have a negative slope. So it means if I were to graph it, I would be going down as I went to the right. So we talked about the vertical lines and horizontal lines. So I'm going to go back to that piece here real quick. You have this on your handout. And again, you want to make sure you print it off. But I want to look back at that piece. So this is actually on your notes from 3.2. And we had these, and I said really important spot to have a summary that you're reminding yourself. So I always suggest these are ones that don't follow the general rules normally. Best idea is to draw a picture if you know it's a special case. How do we know it's a special case? It's one variable if it's an equation. If they tell me it's parallel or perpendicular to an axis, it will be a special case. And also, if they tell me the slope is zero or undefined, which I mentioned to you last lecture in 3.2. Now, there's an easy way to remember this. If you actually plugged in points, it will come out to be zero. So if you were to plug in points on the horizontal line, you actually will get 0 over some number, okay? So that's always 0. Over here on the vertical line, you will get a 0 in the denominator because if I subtract the x's, they will match, and we cannot divide by 0. But if you draw your picture, I want to ask you, when you look at this graph, what do you do when you go from left to right on your graph? Can you ski on this, and what will the change be? Will it be a positive change, meaning you're going uphill? Is it a negative when you're going downhill? And in this case, this special case, I could ski this line, but my elevation is not changing. So that's why it has a zero slope. This would be cross-country skiing. So I would be able to ski it, yes. It's a little more work, so I would be able to ski, but I'm not changing the elevation. So one way to do is looking at the picture. Also, I can form the letter Z with that line. Just get a short tidbit to help remember it. On my vertical line, you cannot ski directly up a cliff. Okay? So this would be, again, that's the idea of this, directly straight up or in the straight down. If you were to ski down, obviously, again, it wouldn't work. You can't ski as you go left to right on this one. So this is the reason why this one's undefined. And you can form the letter N from that piece. So I want to stress, go back, pause this if you need to. Super important that you can data dump these two because they don't follow the general rules. So I'm back on the handout for 3.4. So we have on the top here, again, just a reminder about the vertical and horizontal slope, but I really, really recommend you draw the picture first to be able to do these problems. Want you to realize that you can actually take rise over run from a graph. And again, two ways to do this piece. I'm gonna blow this up a little bit more. So this point right here is -1, 1. The second point is -3, 4. So you could use your slope formula to find that. So you could do 1 - 4, -1 - -3. And again, always double check. -1, 1 is a point, -3, 4 is a point. So this would be giving me a -3 on the top. I'm gonna end up with a -1 + 3 on the bottom there. That's gonna give me a -3/2. So I can get it using my slope formula. Some of you can actually reason it out on the graph. So again, be careful. It's change in Y over change in X. So I always go left to right. So if I go left to right from this point, my Y value is going down 1, 2, 3. So that's why it's down as a -3. And I'm going to the right 1, 2. So I can do it from the graph. The common thing to make a mistake there is signs. So remember here, the idea of skiing, if I skied left to right, I'm skiing downhill. This is going downhill as I go to the right. So that's a double check on your sign. So looking at example 2 here, using our formula, -2 - 3, 8 - 8, I get a -5/0, which again, reminder, I have two spots I can have 0 when I'm dealing with division. This one spells the word on, so this is 0. This one spells the word no, so this is undefined. I cannot divide by 0, so this is my undefined slope. If you're starting to second guess yourself, again, I want you to realize that you could sketch this out. I would have the point 8, 3, and I would have the point 8, -2. This would be my vertical line, which I cannot ski. I always recommend sketching the picture if you can on a special case. So first way to find slope, you have to have two points. You have to memorize the formula. Second way to find slope is if you're given an equation of a line. If you are given an equation of the line, if you can solve it and put it in terms of y equals, then you can pull the slope and the y-intercept from it. Please be careful. The slope is the coefficient of the x term. The y-intercept is the point 0, b, not just b. So please be careful on that. So two ways. Given two points, use your slope formula, which is the first one that I highlighted. Second one, given an equation. So if you're given an equation, this isn't going to tell you this on the directions on the test. You have to put it in the form of y equals mx plus b. So I'm going to take, on this example 3, subtract 3x from both sides, and then divide everything by 2. So I get y equals a -3/2 x + 3. So my slope is the coefficient. Do not include the x on that. That's really important. So it's -3/2. My y-intercept is the point 0, 3. This leads you back to test 2, though, in solving for a single variable. So this is why we actually were doing that. So on number 4, I'm going to subtract 4x from both sides. And then you have to be careful. I have a -1 in the front, so I need to divide every piece by a -1. I get y equals +4x + 8. So my slope here is 4. My y-intercept is 0, 8. Now, the last two are kind of, again, a special case. Example 5, only one variable. yes, you can flat memorize it, but remember what I said. I think it's a good idea to always sketch the graph when you're doing these. So this is a y equals, which means it has a y-intercept at 0, negative 4. So I have a y-intercept at 0, negative 4, which means I have to be a horizontal line. So I can ski this line, but I don't change elevation, so my slope is 0. I answered my questions looking at a graph. I really highly recommend that. Last example, number 6. My goal again is to get y by itself on both sides, so I'm going to divide both sides by negative 2. So I get y equals a negative 5 halves x. I'm going to rewrite that just so you can see. Doesn't matter. I can put them on either side. So my slope is negative 5 halves, and my y-intercept here is the origin because there was no constant term there. Last idea for this section is dealing with parallel and perpendicular lines. Parallel lines have the same slope. Perpendicular lines have a negative reciprocal. You need to memorize this. So parallel lines, same slope. Perpendicular lines means that if I multiply them together, I will get negative 1. Please check that because it says you flip it and take the opposite sign. A lot of people make a mistake on the test for that one. So parallel slope, for example, 7 just means keep the same slope. So I have negative 3, as I have 3, negative 1, 4, and parallel slope would be 0 for that special case. Perpendicular says flip it and take the opposite sign. So I have a negative 1/3. On this one, I flip it, it becomes 4 over 1, which is 4. It becomes a positive 4 since I flip the signs. Special cases is either a zero slope or undefined because I'm going from horizontal to vertical or vertical to horizontal. So this would have a undefined slope. And again, the reason why is that that slope over there would have been 0 over 1. So when I flip it, becomes 1 over 0, which is an undefined slope. Last example, and you will have one like this on the test for sure. You're going to look at something and ask if it's parallel, perpendicular, or neither. If you see the words parallel or perpendicular, it refers to find the slope because that's what it's referring to. So two ways to find slope. From two points, you use your slope formula. Or if you're given an equation of a line, you put it in y equals mx plus b form. So this first one already is in y equals mx plus b form, so the slope is 3. My second one, subtract 3x to both to the other side, and so my slope for my second one is a negative 3. These do not exactly match, which means they're not parallel. If I multiply 3 times negative 3, I get negative 9. So my answer here is neither. I'm going to show you an example of just one I made up that I see a lot of people make mistakes on their quiz and their homework. So say the first slope is 5/7 and the second slope is negative 5/7. I get a lot of times people will say that that's perpendicular, but if I multiply those together, I get a negative 25 over 49. To be perpendicular, it has to give me a negative 1. So that is neither as well. So really important. Make sure you know two ways to find slope. Memorize it. Data dump it. Make sure you understand what parallel perpendicular means.